Fourth station, Jesus meets his afflicted mother. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. To what can I liken you? To what can I compare you, O daughter of Jerusalem? What likeness can I use to comfort you, O virgin daughter of Zion? For vast as the sea is your ruin. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. The Lord will be your everlasting light, and your days of mourning shall be ended.
Twice in the stations of the cross, Jesus encounters his mother, here and when his body is laid in her arms. A sword will pierce your own soul also, said Simeon to Mary, when she and Joseph brought the infant Jesus to the temple. And here that statement comes to fulfillment. I can feel these words. I feel them most profoundly when I consider my own son, not much more than an infant. When he is hurt or sad, it's almost as though I feel real pain myself, and I can only imagine this gets worse as he, his hurts and his sadnesses, get bigger and harder to solve. I can't imagine meeting him on the path to his death. But it is not just in parenting that we know this piercing sword. We can feel something of its sting whenever we must witness those we love struggling or in pain. This, too, is part of the way of the cross, being in the role of loving bystander, powerless to fix what is wrong, but loving all the same.
A sword will pierce your own soul also and fill your heart with bitter pain. Let us pray. O God, who willed that in the passion of your Son a sword of grief should pierce the soul of the Blessed Virgin Mary, his mother, mercifully grant that your church, having shared with her in his passion, may be made worthy to share in the joys of his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.